So this is probably the most precise and rigid Z-axis modification that you can make on this KP3S cantilever style 3D printer. The stock version of it comes with palm wheels and a regular lead screw. Both the wheels and a brass nut are the sacrificial parts in this basic and cost-effective setup. But considering that companies could source all these upgrade parts at way lower prices than ordering in bulk, raises the question why no one does it. Is it solely due to just increasing profit margins, or is it modded? Well, this is why today I'm exploring this topic and will be showing you exactly how much or how little these upgrades improve the print world and what advantages and disadvantages they bring to the table. So let's find out more. The smooth and rigid motion systems always fascinate me, and it was only a question that I would make an upgrade like this. But to make it is not that simple when you have to reverse engineer around obstacles and find the best viable solution. However, after a couple of versions, I end up with a design like this. Printing it from plastic sadly is not an option. Thankfully, PCBWay agreed to sponsor this testing video and CNC'd it from aluminum, and it looks absolutely stunning. I was so excited to test it out. But with that said, I think we all knew that an upgrade like this comes at a way higher cost than the common solution of palm wheels and a basic lead screw. But hey, the closer to the limit you push, the steeper the prices go up. That is a pretty natural phenomenon. So first, let's make some before upgrade test prints. Those with previous ones, where I tested different nozzle sizes, will give enough samples to make a diverse range of examples. And just to note, I have all the G-code files from that video, and the printer configuration didn't change in any way for apples to apples comparison. This looks just sick, but please keep in mind that aligning everything will take way more time than with a regular setup, especially when using a rigid coupling for true one-to-one motion transfer. Linear rails and ball screws are very stiff, and even a small misalignment can cause binding issues. This is why I have to give another advantage to the common solution. But I think we all have been waiting for the comparison of the prints. And before that, I have to note a very important thing, the lighting angle. I can't stress this enough, it makes such a big difference in perceived 3D print quality that you can make every print look good. So please keep in mind that I'm trying to expose all the imperfections for the best visual comparison. With that said, here are the results. And the difference is, well, extremely minimal to say the least. The prints with the upgraded Z-axis just look a tiny bit more consistent, but again, the difference is almost non-existent. Same with a Cal Dragon test print. Or maybe I should say a completely different situation, because there was absolutely nothing but would tip scale in one or another direction. But maybe we get a noticeably better quality at faster speeds, as this modification also brings less wobble on the X-axis rail to the Y direction compared to the stock palm wheel solution. While again, both prints look almost identical, we can only spot a tiny bit more consistent layers in the smaller details. Nothing groundbreaking. So I inhaled some more copium and said, this must be the filament's fault. The more consistent diameter and more fluid filament must make the more consistent extrusion and better show the difference in this comparison. But with a different filament, the Cal Dragon prints looked, well, again, almost identical. Only a couple spots looked a tiny bit different. Here, unless I have time to observe two prints, I can't consistently tell which one is which. And please keep in mind that it is harder to show these imperfections on camera than to spot them by looking at the print directly. So this is probably the best angle for you to show the difference on the precision cube test print. There is more consistency with the upgrade, again not much, and mainly the sides look better. I really like this shot, as it sums up overall difference pretty well. I also checked prints under the microscope, and yeah, I have nothing more to say than I already said. However, this is where things get more interesting. Checking these two different configurations with a runout gauge, we can see that the precision in Z-axis movement is not a lie. It is dead on with the upgrade. Not to mention that I also increased Z-axis speed and acceleration 4 times with linear rails and ball screw setup compared to the stock one. We're talking about acceleration values that NR3 has by default on the X and Y axis. Isn't it kinda crazy when you think about it? This not only looks mesmerizing in action, but also can cut significant time amounts on prints where you want to Z-hop a lot for the maximum print rate success. But I think this aspect is more relevant for 3D printing enthusiasts who like to play and push their machines to the limit, ignoring the cost. Nonetheless, two more advantages go on the list. Other aspects of a setup like this are longevity, consistency and maintenance. Longevity-wise, linear rails and ball screws will last way longer with minimal maintenance, giving you the most consistent results in the long run. Both of them have these plastic parts that wipe the path, keeping the rolling balls clean inside. So we have three more advantages on the list. But this metal-on-metal action brings another aspect, the noise, as all the vibrations of the motor are transferred through this extremely rigid assembly. It is not noticeable with regular Z-speeds and accelerations, but the further you push, the exponentially louder it gets. Not a huge problem, but just something to note. And finally, the luck of a draw that inexpensive linear motion parts from AliExpress can be. The ones I received were okay and like usually only needed lubrication and moving back and forth. But if you get unlucky and receive a wobbly ball screw, then it can make things very difficult, as it is so rigid. So then, what is my conclusion from all this? Would I upgrade my other printers with a solution like this? Well, it is not a short answer. Upgrading the one small printer that you love the most and which has such a simple but effective design, that makes sense. But upgrading multiple just doesn't justify the cost and complexity-wise for the improvement that you get. And 3D printers that have dual Z motors are already precise enough in this regard. Rather than for enthusiasts, I don't think that upgrade like this brings enough benefits, and especially if you print at higher layers, the Z-axis imperfect movement will be less noticeable. But if all you do is print extremely thin layers, this extra precision will see the most benefit as the precise Z-axis movement will be more critical here. Hopefully, I covered all the important aspects for those who were interested or even planned an upgrade like this. If you have a question about it, feel free to ask. Also, check out my other videos to see the great close-up comparisons of how certain things affect the print quality. Thanks for everyone who supported or still supports the channel. If you want to contribute, check the links in the video description or at the end of the video. That's all from me, and we'll see you next time.